Okay, I guess we're live. Make sure everything's working. How's everybody doing? Okay, so we discussed this last time, but today we're doing Hey You. Warforged samurai or wannabe samurai. He thinks he understands the way of Bushido, but he has no idea. The player character, or the player, has to roll a die at random to see if certain scenarios are for or against the rules of Bushido. And typically, if they are against his code, he will attack it. So let's see. He has a little round little head. He also has plates all over. I don't know, gives it something like this. Kind of like that, only less like dad head shaped. Again, this is just like a concept. drawing Hei Yu is definitely weird, because it's like trying to figure out like muscle groups and stuff. And it's not all all of the plates are not necessarily all muscle. It's like bone too, you can see the collarbone. But it's all like segmented to sort of look like plates of armor. And what I want to do, I think I want like him to be holding his Kanabo over his shoulder. And Kanabo is a studded club. Probably shouldn't start from Kanabo out. Let's do head. Let's see if we can figure this out first. Should we be looking up? I think he should be looking up because he's very kind of like hopeful. Square jaw. Okay. Okay, I think that's a good start. That's right. We're doing it in red. I don't want to blind everybody. I keep forgetting that I'm the only one who can really see it in gray, and everybody else is blind to that red. But that's just how I draw it, you know? Helps me sort of figure out. I'm just doing it in a different color, like instead of in black, I can take this later and just decrease the opacity by like a crap ton. And then, color over it with black later and sticks out a lot more, a lot better, whatever. Okay. He should have an ear of some sort, maybe just a hole in his head. That works. Seriously playing ads? I don't know what happened to my Spotify account, but it seems to have been broken somehow. That's cool. Love that. Sorry, everybody.
Kroger brand. offer proven quality at lower than low prices. In fact, we guarantee that you and your family will love how Kroger brand products taste, or you get your money back. So next time you're shopping for the family, look for delicious Kroger brand products, because they'll make you all feel like you're winning.
Switch to YouTube music. I'll have to find some copyright-free music on YouTube, like a playlist or something, before I can do that. Right now, I only have what's on Spotify, because that's what I found in a hurry before a stream a couple streams ago. But yeah, you're right. I should invest in finding one on YouTube Music, because there's no ads on my YouTube Music, because we share it on premium. Okay, that's his stupid head. Think of a pose next time before. Yeah. Definitely have his Kanaba over his shoulder, which should mean that this shoulder is dipped. And his shoulder is raised. So do like leaning this way. If I have him straight up and then out, give him a little sassy pose. Probably not. Could give him weird straight up and down. I'm trying to think, like, I don't know what a good pose for him is. Also, he's like super low. Yeah, like that. Shoulder, hip. Sort of make them crunched and stretched. That looks a little too sassy. Maybe decrease that. I don't know if I really want him that sassy. Let's see. Figuring out a pose. Stance straight up and down. What if one leg bent for some reason and the other out behind him? Do bring arm in front and over shoulder and then like twist the torso. So give him like this twisted look. Brings the Kanaba over his shoulder. Have to bring his leg up. So twist him like that, and then this one. give him a big crazy twist here. Honestly, that's cool and I like it. It's just this way. That way I can actually, because he's supposed to be like, one of the stupid things that Michael said about his character. Not stupid things, it's actually kind of funny. The Warforged is anatomically correct. It's one of the things that I constantly have to do with this character is block off certain areas. I kind of wonder. It's a really good pose for him. And then, like, one of the worst things about making Hei Yu is all of his plates. I have to remember some of the forms. Like I said, it's part muscle, part other things. That's a penis. You made it to the stream. I'm glad you're here. Thanks for the support. Okay, so yeah, these are just like the basic shapes and stuff. It's just the rough. I'll have to flesh out like a bunch of stuff. How do you get some of these abs? Work out really hard. Technically, you already have these abs. Everyone does. Just whether or not it's visible. Okay, I think that's a pretty good rough. Let's start doing... start doing some inking. Crank it way down. Been buried since birth. Well, that's all right. And some people have to get anorexic skinny in order to show those abs. So don't do that. Just be happy that your muscles still work, regardless of whether or not they're visible. Okay. Moo. The worst part is like, I keep saying the worst part. Honestly, drawing Hei Yu is a pain in the ass. Just all the way around. But like, another difficult thing about drawing Hei Yu is he's a robot. So if he's not perfect, it's weird. But since I am human and drawing him, he's just gonna have to deal with being lopsided. His face beans. Gotta draw those face beans. Honestly, his head is covered in beans. He got face beans everywhere. That face is so lopsided. But you know what? Whatever. That's fine. And those are his face plates. And then later we have to go through the entire body. Because he has sinew. This cool thing about Warforged is that they're kind of robots and kind of not. that's a little better. Okay. Ooh, that's thick. Making weird muscle things, la la la. Some look like bones, some look like muscles, some look like they don't belong there. Does that look like a thumb? There we go. Better. That does need to be moved out. Over there for now, and then try and figure this out. Sorry, looking at reference real quick. It's a good circle, I don't want to waste it. That should be more over here. Out this way. Honestly, the muscle now seems off. Again, it's not muscle, but at this point, the elbow should actually be in line over here. I think, yeah, I should be able to adjust it. sad that I have to erase this, though, because it was a really good... I think it was really good. I liked the shape of it. Okay, but we are going to have to move this elbow. I should go up there. Oh, the tricep muscle. Oops. Or technically that's the tendon. Lines up perfectly. That's pretty good. Gives me hope. Anyway, so twisted bone. Kind of comes in here like that. So the forearm internal muscle goes this way. Again, not muscle, just the plate. Anatomy's hard, yo. And then this thing probably should shrink and move over. Stop doing that. Yes, and then the bone. Comes over here. That's weird. Okay, that works. Bodies are weird. Anatomy's weird. But it also kind of makes sense too, you know? And that's like confusing and complicated, but you know what the hell in life isn't, right? Honestly, we just kind of making up anatomy just to whatever looks aesthetically cool. Use that external bone. Okay, and then there is one giant plate that covers the hand. And then individual knuckle bones or plates. And each finger. Each phalange has its separate plates as well. Good. Okay. This has to be collarbone. Goes down. connecting lines. Now I'm trying to figure out this mess. I have one of the back plates come out under this. And chest plate. Pretty good. Then we got this. Might just stick with three ribs on each side. I like the ribs. The ribs look awesome. These things are called. Actually, that was kind of good. Yeah, I like that. Okay. Something like that, maybe? Possibly? Kind of looks good. I think it looks good. We're gonna keep it. And then... That's the butt. The butt wraps around just a little bit. That's not bad. I'll keep that one. My god. DoorDash keeps getting on my ass because I like applied to Drive. And it's so weird. I've never had a I've never had a delivery service like reach out to me and be like, hey, you gonna do this for us? Like, they must be desperate around here. Which I guess is good. Make some money doing that while I'm not drawing. But if you'd like to help support me, you can find the link in my About section to my Patreon. That would be super cool. I would love you forever. That way I don't have to do DoorDash. I would love that. I'm drawing at a really weird angle here, and I know I can rotate the canvas, but like, I haven't figured out the shortcut for that yet. So we're just twisting our body here. Because screw it. Ooh, that's a good straight line. Identity theft issues, and all LifeLock plans are backed by Yeah, that's pretty good too. About there.
Hey, it's Kaylee Cuoco for Priceline. Ready to go to your happy place for a happy price? Well, why didn't you say so? Just download the Priceline app right now and save up to 60% on hotels. So whether it's Cousin Kevin's kazoo concert in Kansas City, go Kevin, or Becky's bachelorette bash in Bermuda, you never have to miss a trip ever again.
Sorry about the commercials again. Those toes are weird. I'm drawing them backwards. Delete toes. Okay. I had to figure out how to rotate this canvas because it's killing me. There we go. Okay. No, that's still weird. Why is it weird? I'm good at drawing toes. Is it because I have the ball of the foot? That's a good toe. Fits perfectly. Okay, so the angle was weird. Is it always, when it comes down to the ball of the foot, it's weird. I feel like maybe it should be spread out more. Honestly, no, I think the first one is good. I think it's this one. Oh, what am I doing? I'm gonna do outside first. Is that good? That looks good. But then this. What is it about this? Go away. That looks fine. It's like no matter what angle I do it at, it's not. Okay. There's a good ball of the foot. And now the outside curve. It's the heel. It's the heel that's the problem. Because the heel should be. Okay. Yes. There we go. Okay. Try not to make it so sketchy. Sketch looks good, and then just kind of take out all of the excess to make it more of an ink. Hands and feet, probably the hardest things to draw, but I am very good at doing both. I just have to get out of my own stupid head and actually draw it like I know I can. And if I spent an extra long time, I could make it look real, 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 real good. Okay. You know, for somebody who does not have a foot fetish, I spend a lot of time on these feet. Looks great so far, thanks. That's what I was going for. Okay. That is one leg. Oops. Not what I wanted. Come on. What am I trying to do here? Oh, okay. Yes. That's what I want. Okay. Now this one. A lot easier to work with. That looks good there. Let's work on the arm. The opposite arm. Almost done with the ink. Yes. Fingies. Knuckles. Yeah, I think that's good shape. Like I said, fingers, hands, feet, not that hard. As long as you know what you're doing. A lot of people struggle. And actually, if you kind of use drawing of Hei Yu here, you can do something like this as like a guide to making your hands and feet easier to draw. So do something like that with the sections. And actually, it looks like I was a little off. Just remember when you're drawing your fingies that they fan out Oh, no, that's weird. They fan out from the center. Like that. Out, 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 out. Sort of like that. I think that looks good. Let's zoom out again. Honestly, it looks like the fingers could be a little bit longer, but... could do that. Oh, that is a wonky. Typically, your fingers, depending on the type of hand you have, I should say the length of the fingers depend on the type of hand you have, because some people have long fingers and short palms, and some people have long palms and short fingers. Some people, like me, my fingers are as long as my palm. And some people read into like what that says about you, but honestly, it's not all true. So. Remember, he's a robot and all the lines are closed. All the shapes are closed. Lines connected. All right, that looks better. So now time to connect everything. Let's start top left, because they're right-handed. And that's the way that I like to start, top left to bottom right. Okay, connections. Again, a horrible thing about Hei Yu. He's got a ton of little lines. Those little lines, excuse me, are going to be dark gray. I'm going to take one of these empty layers and I'm going to use that for the lines. We'll call them in-betweens. Okay. this down to 20. And what we try to do is like in the comic itself, try to minimize the amount of lines that I have to draw, just because it's not nice to have to draw so many damn lines. Held together by magic, drawn by... Ugh. That's all I can say is ugh. Keeping an eye out for anything that's overlapped the ink portion. Let's get this arm before we go on to the rest of it. What did we have here? Oh. Make sure that looks okay. Yeah, it does look good. It's fine. Looks okay. For the rest of them, I think of like how the muscle groupings go, and how it looks like when someone loses their skin. Whoa, why is that huge? Oh. I got the shapes brush. Oh, is that an ink layer? Oops. Happened. Okay, this just looks weird for some reason. Nothing going over. This is going over. Okay. It's just a lot of monotonous work. And typically when I'm doing monotonous work, I get a little quiet, so I'm sorry. I just listen to the weird music in the background. looks good. Looks good there. I'm just gonna do the last leg. Excess lines out of there. That's on the ink layer, of course it is. Okay, I think that's inked. I just had to add the Kanabo. Let's just get it on the rough real quick. Okay. And this one is out of 5. Right, because it's lower opacity. Fun fact about Hei Yu's Kanabo. and his ability to use it, he strikes at what Michael said was non-Euclidean angles. He basically cuts things with his blunt object. I don't understand it, but Michael's very sciencey and he explained it. It's very funny. That no matter how hard he tries to bludgeon something, he will always cut it. It's amusing. Oh, that's the rough. What am I doing?
Hi, my name's Enrique. A little thing I love about Chick-fil-A's spicy deluxe sandwich is you get that rich flavor of the chicken and definitely that nice tangy.
Let's do
perfect harmony of spiciness and taste.
Where's my rotate? 90. All right. I can draw straight lines better downward. Oh, there we go. Okay, not bad. I'll take it. Somehow makes this real big line here. That's good. Like that. Okay. Okay. I can use this. Awesome. Good. And then can take the rough off. Just leave it the way it is. No need to fuss with it so much that we ruin it. One other thing the Kanabo has. Let's is sometimes they'll have metal studs in them, so right, that's a layer below. It's be really annoying because I have to do like a billion of these. Let's label our layer because we are definitely going to screw up if we don't. Studs. Oh, and the freaking in-betweens. They can go into the ink layer now. They are now one layer. Okay. What if I draw like a really good circle and then just like copy it and shrink it for each? That's a pretty good circle. Okay, and if I just do that, just like copy and paste. Smaller. Copy and paste a little smaller. Honestly, this just seems to be working out just fine. What if instead of straight line down, we take and we shift it over? That, I guess, and then we're just going to now they're all in the studs layer. I'll take that and we're gonna move that over. merge down, and merge down. Is that enough? I think one more layer should do it. Easier is we just keep doing this. I can do the same thing, like do a copy and paste on each of the side nodules, but I don't know. I feel like these ones would look weird copy and pasted. Like, they look good, but I don't know. I feel like it might be too much. Yeah, we're just gonna manually do each one. I know we've gone over time by like 5 minutes right now, but honestly, I kind of knew that was going to happen with Hei Yu. As you've seen, he's very intricate. Takes a lot of attention to detail with his character. But you know what? It's worth it. Like I said, detail. Honestly, putting in the effort to do those details really pays off. And if the commercials could shut the fuck up,
Family, look for delicious Kroger brand products. Because-
everyone.
Okay. Now that's speaking the Lowe's language. This one can just use one.
My Lowe's rewards, your savings just keep coming. Save money with member-only offers and earn points when you shop. More points equal more rewards just for you. Because Lowe's knows you earned it, literally. Learn more about our new loyalty program at Lowe's.com/MyLowe'sRewards. Program subject to terms and conditions. Points are awarded on eligible purchases. See Lowe's.com/terms for full details. Subject to change.
Hi, my name is Alani. A little thing I like about the spicy deluxe sandwich is that you taste the crunch, you taste the pepper jack cheese melting, and you taste the spicy flavors in the sandwich. I'm telling you, 10 out of 10.
Hi, my name's Enrique. A little thing I love about Chick-fil-A's spicy deluxe sandwich is...
No, fuck you, Chick-fil-A. Y'all can fuck right off. Racist, homophobic, transphobic piece of shit company. Sorry, we're gonna have to do this last bit in kind of silence. I don't know. I know how to talk over things. I'm just not good at talking sometimes, so sorry. All right, so there's his Kanabo. I might put more detail on it later, just like add some like wood grain on it or something, but I might also do that in like the coloring stage like I did with Frasier's background with a tree. So that is probably it for the end of the stream. I hope you all enjoyed it. I actually got to take it up to 2 hours this time, so I had a lot of fun. Don't forget to follow my channel, and if you feel like supporting me, go over to my Patreon. It's in my About Me section here on Twitch, and follow me on all the other social medias. I should either be under Team Jesse, or you can find me under Shayna Moonchild. Either one. Thank you for joining me. I will see you next time. Bye.